And you have written in a similar vein about the rise of mass incarceration and locating it, of all places, maybe counterintuitively, in Lyndon Johnson's Great Society. That's the starting point for this story that you're telling. That's a surprise to a lot of readers, I'm sure. Can you explain that, the origin story?
So, I mean, on one level, there's this kind of tendency in U.S. history to ramp up new laws and prison systems, forms of incarceration, when rights are extended to new groups of people. So when we get civil rights legislation in 64, 65, we then get the war on crime. In fact, Johnson sent the first federal crime bill in the history of the United States to Congress, the Law Enforcement Assistance Act, in 1965. And then a week later, he sends the Voting Rights Act. So that kind of gives you a sense of Johnson's priorities, right? Extending civil rights, voting rights, dismantling Jim Crow, while at the same time introducing a whole new system of policing and surveillance, and eventually one that's really kind of searing new levels of incarceration. His Great Society, as far as Black Americans go, is this real kind of carrot and stick approach to preventing urban civil disorder, which we know doesn't effectively work to stop incidents of uprisings. In fact, they only kind of increase in intensity through every summer of Johnson's presidency. And the steering behind this choice is policymakers, Johnson's and Kennedy's, frankly, own assumptions about Black Americans' poverty and crime.